Hello everyone. So we continue the topic Machiavelli. Some people want to know what were the religious views of Machiavelli. Of course, the question is justified because Machiavelli separated religion from politics. Some questions which have been asked: was he atheist? Was he a pagan? And why he was anti-Christianity? Some questions are very sensitive. Some questions are logical. When we ask, was he an atheist? There is no mention in books and biographies about his religious beliefs, to which religion he belonged, which deity he worshipped. So the simple answer is that no, he was not an atheist. Or rather, it is unknown whether he was a God-fearing person or he was an atheist. Not clear. We close the matter here. Similarly, was he a pagan? For that, we need to know what is paganism. All religions before Christ are usually termed as paganism. Now, what did the pagans do? They worshipped multiple, now deities. That is one, or we can say gods. These gods were immortals with special powers, could be male as well as female forms. Unlike monotheist religions like Christianity, single God, male, pagans worshipped different forms of perceived immortal gods, who could be male, who could be female, for gaining their favors. There is no question of afterlife, rebirth, virtue,
wise.
You worship the God through prayers. You try to make the God happy with sacrifices to attain their grace.
No virtues, no vices. Virtues and vices were social constructs. That was your social behavior.
This was paganism. It was practiced. The cause of reason is, the cause of this doubt is that ancient Rome was such a society.
Worshipping immortals with special powers in male or female forms for different kinds of gains through prayers and sacrifices.
Greek also. Indians till date, they worship multiple gods who exist in male forms, female forms, and even can change their form. Christianity was not a legal religion in Rome till 3 CE. Right? After 3 CE, the king of Rome, he recognized Christianity as a legal religion, and Christianity spread with royal patronage.
So,
pagans worship nature also through seasonal festivals.
This is paganism. Christianity, we know, based on virtues and vices, single God, afterlife, concept of saints, for which we may be punished later on.
So when we say immortals with special powers, these people were heroes.
People who had that virtue about which
Machiavelli talks,
who could accomplish things.
Whereas Christianity, it's saints, people who are virtuous as per Christianity. Till this, this is the background of paganism, and Christianity, was he anti-Christianity or was he a pagan?
No. When we read Machiavelli,
things somewhere become confusing if we take them at face value. In The Prince, he says religion should be kept aside. In The Discourses, he says, unfortunate is the country which has to block or inhibit religious functions because religion joins people. means he says in republics religion is good. In monarchy or principality religion is bad. Plus he says that the Christian concept of virtues and vice has made people meek. They are afraid of the result of their sins. That is point number one. He thinks the Christian concept of virtues and vices has made people meek. They don't want to fight. They are afraid of the sins for which they will be punished. There was no such concept in the earlier religions. The second thing to be understood is what Machiavelli said, or rather what is the most famous phrase used for him: the ends are the means. What are the ends? Stable nation. As a principality or as a republic. So in this concept, when we add religion, religion, if it helps in creating a stable nation, is okay. If it helps in creating an unstable nation, this is to be shunned. So at time of Machiavelli, what was happening? Machiavelli says, four Italian states, one papal state, plus Germany, France, Spain, Britain, out of four, these four we make it three, and Florentine. This was the geopolitical scenario of Europe at his time, and he thought Germany interferes, can interfere, France interfered, Spain interfered, Britain could interfere, Papal State could interfere in the internal affairs of Florentine. Now to stop their interference in internal affairs, he said, the king must be well armed. If you are not armed, you won't be considered weak, but you would be despised. So the legal borders can be protected with the help of army. But the Pope could interfere in the internal affairs even after a strong army, due to the religious belief of people. And Machiavelli was of the thought that Christianity makes people meek. Not exactly weak, but meek. So people are not ready to take decisive actions or not ready to resort to cruelty when desired and required. Machiavelli took this thing as the biggest interference in the internal affairs of Florentine as well as other Italian states. Religion unites. He writes, when? At peacetime. He says republics are more stable, people are more self-regulated, they have right to celebrate festivals. But when people are allowed to worship their local deities, what used to happen? There was a local deity. The protector of a town or village, of a clan, the family deity, which people used to worship. When you have a deity which is specific to your area and you worship, you identify yourself and you relate yourself with that particular area. This may be the reason that when you worship a local deity, you align with that area psychologically, that I belong to this region. This is my local deity. I must make him happy because I belong to this region. This is my family deity. I must seek his or her blessing. So you associate with the clan. When a nation has its own local deities and people worship, they identify with that deity as a nation. So we can say he was vocal for local. Christianity also unites. All religions unite people. But Christianity didn't unite people of Florentine or Italy as people of Italy. It united people as Christians. And when we see that Pope was able to interfere, so this did not, that unification of people did not serve the purpose of Machiavelli, who wanted people to associate with Italy as a nation. But he says in earlier Rome, people were allowed and those people, they identified with the local deities as Romans or as Greeks. So Italy also must be having its own local deities which were put aside. That is the only reason that he was anti-Christianity. Additional input is that he mentions the story of Borgia, who was related to the then Pope Alexander, for whom the Pope bribed Romanians so that he could acquire Romania. Forces were arranged and the Pope was a monk and was expected to be celibate. He had a son. So what was being preached to people was not being practiced by the Pope at that time himself,
plus because Pope bribed, so Machiavelli was afraid that he could destabilize Florentine also by bribing people, by indulging in corrupt practices. So those virtues, you will not indulge in immoral behavior, you will not indulge in adultery, you will practice fidelity. All these things which were being preached but not being practiced, that also was an additional input. So, thinking like Machiavelli, we can say that sense of nationality in people is required, sense of discipline is required when the people are self-disciplined, religious morality, is not required. So, any religion if it supports in creating sense of nationality is good. Any religion or any list of virtues and vices, it be legal or it be religious, if it creates in, helps in creating a sense of nationality, is welcome. Any grouping which acts acts against the national interest should be kept aside. His views about Christianity. He talks about the armed prophets always win. There we talk of papal forces, the Pope had forces, the Pope had resources, they had missionaries, they were converting people, and by converting people, it didn't fit into his idea of a nation, his idea of Italy as a nation. The people may be uniting as Christians, but they were not uniting as Italians, which was his aim of a strong state. Even today, politicians, they use religion for their benefit. Even in Rome, they use religion for their benefit to keep people happy. He says, give some moments of happiness and joy to people by small gifts, some schemes, religious festivals. All these things, they are still being practiced. So, Machiavelli For Machiavelli, religion as a tool in favor of king was the only thing where religion was useful. We should not go into other details. He believed in God. These things are very personal. So when he says keep law and administration separate from religion, he himself may also have kept so. In interest of nation, religion may be supported. In interest of nation, religion may be shunned. In India, in pre-independence India, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, he advocated celebration of Ganesh Chaturthi. Till date, people in Maharashtra, they celebrate it. So that united Indians as Hindus or as Indians, not as a part of a British colony. The Britishers had no interest, but it united the then Indians as Indians, that this is not a festival of the British, this is our festival. So if tomorrow someone says that Bal Gangadhar Tilak advocated the celebration of Ganpati Utsav or Ganpati celebrations, so we cannot say that that writer, he has a faith in Lord Ganesh. But he is saying that for Indians that was important. So Roman local gods were important for Romans in uniting them as Romans. Paganism was not limited to Roman. By definition, all pre-Christian religions which involved God in multiple forms, nature worship, sacrifices, omens, all these things, divinations, they are called pagans. I hope this makes it clear. The ends are the means. If the religion is in favor of the king, it is to be supported. Otherwise, not.